Redeemer and Sustainer. Amen.
Amen. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to today's sofa service, and especially big welcome if you're new today and trying the sofa service for the first time. It's great you're with us. And we'd like to say thank you for all your comments and ideas. Keep them coming. We really enjoy reading them. So today's a very special Sunday, Jonathan.
It's a special Sunday. It is the last Sunday in the church's year. We have told the story, despite all of the COVID restrictions, we have told that story of what God has done for us in Jesus Christ. And so this Sunday we celebrate Christ as King.
Very special indeed.
Christ as King. And the focus for our sofa service today is Christ, who is the King of Love, as we heard in that wonderful hymn based on the words of Psalm 23. I just love that hymn. I love that version too, Jane. Well found.
Well found. Thank you, Spotify.
Indeed, always. Give them a nod. But also today is special because I think, Jane...
Shall I go and get
you
the thing that's...
have something... to share with us,
which is something to share.
All about love.
All
Here
about
we
love.
Go.
I'm going to go and get the thing that's all about love.
Yeah, so when we speak of love, of course, we can mean so many different things. But last Sunday, if you were with us, we spoke of a particular kind of Christ's love, which is a love that is intentional, which is extravagant in nature, and which is always unconditional and freely given. And here is something which is a focus at the moment in our life, only just arrived.
Okay,
there we are.
Arrived. Very
here
new.
Is Brynn. Now Brynn already, the moment that I collected Brynn and brought him home, Janie, I could just see that you were lost in love.
So smitten.
And of course, this little fella, he needs our intentional.
Yeah.
Extravagant.
Hi.
Yes, indeed. And quite unconditional loving.
He does. Yes, here we're having the sleepless nights.
The sleepless night.
The getting up even when the puppy's asleep to check it's still breathing. We're like classic parents, aren't we, with a newborn?
Well,
it's a furry thing.
In love. You do? There we are, and it just came to us straight away, that love, didn't it?
Yeah.
Well, look, we're going to continue with our sofa service, but we feel that probably having Brynn on Jane's lap isn't going to make for the easiest sofa service. So, mate, do you want to say cheerio?
Yeah, I think while you're doing the collect, I'll quietly take you back, and then we'll carry on. And I'm sure you'll see a lot more of Brynn over the coming weeks.
We've got our clickers.
Oh, yes!
And when we
curse.
Do that, we've got to cook them a quick treat. I forgot about that.
Oh, yeah. No, quick.
There we go. There you are, buddy.
There's not a dog training video we have not watched.
Oh, delicious treat.
Lovely.
Right, you take it back,
darling. Right, let's go. We'll see you later.
Yeah. So, the collect for Christ the King. Let us pray. Living God, help us to hear the call of Christ the King, to follow in his service, whose kingdom has no end, for he reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, one glory. Amen. I meant also to say that, of course, it's a special Sunday because it's also your birthday, isn't it?
Yes.
It is your birthday. I need to know that. Yeah.
It is, and you
so
remember.
Happy birthday,
so
Jane. Well, you know, Brynn's kind of a birthday present for several birthdays to come, I think.
I know. Yeah.
Oh, so what's our gospel today?
So our gospel today is from Matthew 25, verses 31 to 46. When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, then he will sit on the throne of his glory. All the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate people one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. And he will put the sheep at his right hand and the goats at his left. Then the king will say to those at his right hand, "Come, you are blessed by my Father. Inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger and you welcomed me. I was naked and you gave me clothing. I was sick and you took care of me. I was in prison and you visited me." Then the righteous will answer him, "Lord, when was it we saw you hungry and gave you food, or thirsty and gave you something to drink? And when was it we saw you a stranger and welcomed you, or naked and gave you clothing? And when was it we saw you sick in prison, and you did it to one, and visited you?" And the king will answer them, "Truly I tell you, just as you did it to me, of the least of these who are members of my family, you did it to me." Then he will say to those on his left, "You are accursed. Depart from me into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry and you gave me no food. I was thirsty and you gave me nothing to drink. I was a stranger and you did not welcome me. I was naked and you did not give me clothing. I was sick in prison and you did not visit me." Then they will also answer, "Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry or thirsty or a stranger or naked or in prison or sick? Did not we take care of you?" Then he will answer them, "Truly I tell you, just as you did not do it to one of the least of these, you did not do it to me." And these will go away into eternal punishment, but the righteous into eternal life.
Just as you did not do it to one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did not do it to me. Such a well-known parable, the sheep and the goats. Again, so many sermons preached on that particular famous parable. Why is it here, though, for us on this Sunday when we celebrate Christ as King? What has it got to say above and beyond simply that Christ is King? Where is the so what in the gospel story? Where is the so what in having Christ as King. I guess if I was to say to you, Jay, Titanic, you'd think of a number of things. I'm guessing as well, because I know you love it, you'd think of the movie that I've always never really loved. I'm not one for, see, I'm not really one for the romantic
I
movie.
I think our children had movie. It on daily, sort of during their early teens. I've seen it a lot.
Yeah, yeah, and we've all done that kind of thing at the prow of the boat, haven't we? Dear Jack and Rose, a story of true love, how true love conquers all, and how in the end, Jack makes sure that Rose lives, and in so doing, he gives his life. It's a love story. Mm. Maybe we should be more relaxed and talk about the Jesus story as a love story, because it's in Jesus that we encounter that love, the intentional, extravagant, unconditional love of His and our Heavenly Father, made real in the life of Jesus. And we are given permission, a green light through baptism, to share in that light and that life. And we, as we journey through life, are invited to become more and more like Jesus, to grow into the full stature of Christ, as Paul says. Well, I heard another Titanic story earlier in the week, and in fact, it was great to see that also dear Reverend Eric had also heard that story and had put it in his in the blog he sends out to our walking group, our Amblers, a great group coming together, caring for each other, numbering about 30 plus people, and they've really cared for each other through this time of lockdown. But I'd like to read you the little account of what happened on the real Titanic, not just in the movie. And you may too have heard that this week a letter was sold for an extraordinary amount of money, £42,000. And it was, of course, even more extraordinary, it was a letter from a Baptist minister. He was called John Harper. And he wrote this letter just before he departed on the SS Titanic. And he has been described as the bravest man, the bravest person on that tragic ship. He was a widower. He had a six-year-old daughter. Now, we all know the scene, and maybe you're seeing now in your mind's eye the movie Titanic, but as the ship was sinking, his daughter was put on a life raft, and he was invited to be with her. But he kept back and gave his place to someone else. He also gave away his life jacket to someone in greater need. And then when eventually he found himself in the water, those who remembered him recalled him encouraging people to put their faith in Jesus and to trust in him even in that desperate situation. Now, that's an example of the Christ love. It's an extraordinary example, maybe an extreme example. But doesn't it once again speak to that intentionality? Yes, an extravagance, an overflowing of love. And moreover, an unconditional giving, with no thought of his own self, but rather laying himself aside for the sake of others. His daughter, that blessed person who had his life jacket, and those whose spirits he encouraged as they flayed together in that icy water. We've all heard in recent days about the new vaccines. We're also encouraged by that. It seems to have lifted that dark cloud of when's it going to end. We're hearing that possibly there might start to be vaccinations available in the middle of December. It's such good news, and we should be encouraged. But I had a fact, look, I haven't fact-checked it, but I think it's probably legit, that really made me reflect on what it means to be unconditional, to be extravagant, but above all, to be intentional as we live out this Christ love. 80% of the vaccines have already been bought by the 14% of the richest nations. That leaves 20% of vaccines left. Come on, give me the maths here. For the 74% of the world's poorest people. Check this out. See how this sits with you. Great Britain will purchase vaccinations first for the poorest. And when the poorest have them, the least of these brothers and sisters of ours, then we will have whatever there is left. How does that sound to you? Does that sound completely ludicrous? Doesn't charity start at home? Isn't it right and prudent that our government should acquire the vaccinations this nation needs for people who really do need to be protected? But you see, you take the so what of Christ the King of love, and you put it slap bang in the middle of the real world in which we really live as real people. And you take that gospel story so well known of the sheep and the goats and how Jesus says, when you did it for the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did it for me. Then suddenly, not only does our faith become alive, but we feel the true force of the power of the Christ life and the Christ love, challenging us to do things just as extraordinary, extravagant, unconditional as that Baptist minister on the Titanic. Talk with people, think through what that means, that 80% of the vaccinations have already been bought by 14% of the world's richest nations, leaving 76% of the poorest nations without a vaccination available for them. What does it mean to walk in the way of Jesus Christ? What might it mean to truly proclaim Christ as your King, as my King? Amen.
Amen. Let's pray. Just take a moment to sit so you're comfortable. To allow yourself to become still. And just take a few slow breaths in and out. As we do so, we invite God's love to flow through us, to live in us, to be at the center of everything we do. God of love, we pray for your strength to give us a voice to speak for those who do not have what we have. We pray for the courage to live the way you ask us to live through your Son. We pray for the world, that each will share the most important things, and that we will turn away from our own greed and selfishness. We give thanks that in our lockdown, the R rate is decreasing, and we ask for encouragement to keep going. We pray for everyone who is separated from their friends, from their family, who are unable to be with the people they love at this very difficult time. We pray that they will know you are with. And we bring before you, God, all those known to us personally who need your prayers. Those who are sick. And we pray for their healing. And those who are dying. We pray for their peace. We pray that they will know you. In the silence of our hearts, we name those before God that we love.
We continue to pray by name for Judy, for Clive, for Caroline, for Derek, Anna Marie, for John, Julian, for baby Rupert, Mum Katie and Dad Sam, and finally we pray that we who claim to walk in the way of your Son and claim him as our King may be subject to his rule. And especially at this time, we pray you would be with our government as they decide how to cope with all the challenges of this COVID pandemic, and especially those which are financial. We know, Lord, that they are considering cutting back on our international aid to the least of the people of this world. What would it be like if only, Lord, they could think of increasing from all that we have, what they give on our behalf to the least of these brothers and sisters of ours. So we gather up these and all our prayers, the prayers we have said in the silence of our hearts, for Charlie too, for Angela, in the words that Jesus gave us to say. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Amen. Well, as we head into the last part of our worship with you this morning, we're going to be listening to a song that, for me, absolutely brings together everything Jonathan has talked about that we have shared with you this morning. The song's called O Love That Will Not Let Me Go. The version we're going to hear is by an artist called Chris Rice. I know that so many of us in this community are having very difficult time with loved ones who are poorly and sick and with loss and grief and all that brings. I know that I've drawn huge comfort this week from the prayer groups that are running every day, our morning and evening prayer. The links take you straight through from that on our website. If you want to join, you just need a Zoom and off you go. And if you need technical help, do call the parish office and we can try and organise someone to come and help you. But those groups are really drawing a huge support, aren't they, to everybody. And it's open to everyone anytime, morning and evening prayer. Oh, love that will not let me go sums it all up for me. In the darkest moments, just sensing that we are being held and sharing that, getting support from others, has been a wonderful thing.
And we're hoping also that as we begin the new year with Advent Sunday next Sunday, you'll be able to join us for a Zoom sofa service. So we're going to be Zooming next Sunday and it will be on Sunday at 10 o'clock. And so we invite you to take the link from the website, from the newsletter, or contact the parish office. And it would be wonderful if we could join together as a church family. And from beyond the immediate church family, we know many of you have come and joined us from far away, and you're really welcome to be with us for that.
The one thing about that technology is it makes our global community suddenly much smaller and more accessible.
And again, you know, maybe it brings us in contact with those who are the least of our brothers and sisters.
And if you need help, do ask, because I know technology can be a bit overwhelming.
Remember, of course, it is actually as well going to be today Stir Up Sunday. I believe that's the Sunday when you begin to prepare your Christmas puddings.
Okay.
So what a wonderful thought that is. Stir up, O Lord, the world's your faithful people, that they plenteously bring forth the fruit of good works.
I've never done that, but maybe today's the day.
You be plenteously rewarded. Stir Up Sunday.
Yeah.
One to remember. Jane, if you'd like to pass my stole to me, because I think as it is a special feast day, Christ the King, it would be good to receive on this Sunday God's blessing. Let us pray. Christ, our exalted King, pour upon you and those you love his abundant gifts and bring you to reign with him in glory. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, love that will not let me go.